الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على المصطفى وآله وصحبه ومن اتقى. أهلا وسهلا والسلام عليكم. We are here doing a class that we find a very big need for it nowadays. This is the Quran class. This whole course that we're going to go through is going to explain to you how to recite the Quran, because we find people really don't know how to do that. So we're going to call this either tidbits of the Quran or advice in reciting. Either way, you tell us. My name is Abu Toba, alhamdulillah. And the first thing that we need to know when reciting the Quran is how to begin reciting the Quran. And there's a particular technique, and we're going to go through it here. The first thing you have to say is, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Now we call this the ta'awudh. It means the way to seek refuge in Allah. Now the words have meaning. أعوذ means I seek refuge. I seek the help and protection. بالله with and in Allah. سبحانه وتعالى. من الشيطان from the shaytan الرجيم who is rejected. This is a title for shaytan. He's the rejected and cursed shaytan. Together that goes أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Now the next line is the Basmalah. Now the Basmalah, it means the statement Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Now those words have two meanings amongst the Mufassirin. The most widespread meaning amongst the scholars of Tafsir is that Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim means utilizing the name of Allah, who is Ar-Rahman, extremely merciful to the entire creation. Ar-Rahim, specifically merciful to the believers. Okay, together it recites Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Now after that, after saying these two lines, the second way that is not so famous for people to know what this line means, it comes in the tafsir, I believe it's Razi, and it comes this way. It means I swear by the name of Allah, subhanahu ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, the one who is extremely merciful to the entire creation, specifically merciful to the believers. And these two meanings are not oppositional, okay? Because we know the ba' in the Arabic language, it means an oath, I swear by, and I'm utilizing only the name of Allah. So of course it still points towards tawheed, meaning that we're singling out Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for our actions that we're about to do. Now there are four ways, after you say these two lines, there are four ways we can say them and before we start reciting the line of Quran, beginning to recite. The first way, we're going to call it Qat'ul Jamir, which means to pause between each line, okay? Because that's what we're going to do. And the way that's done, if we're going to follow it, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. Pause. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Pause. الحمد لله رب العالمين. And we started the reciting with that line, Alhamdulillah. So, that's one way. The second way we're going to do it, we're going to join the ta'awudh and the basmalah, and then we're going to pause before we start reciting the Quran. Now, when we do this, you have to take note. You see this line here? It says, ar-rajim, but it says, ar-rajimi. It has a kasra there. Normally, when we pause, when we stop, we don't pronounce that. We say, ar-rajim. However, when we're joining the ta'awudh with the basmalah, we do recite the rajimi. So we go like this. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. You see, I paused after I joined these two together. That's the second way. Why is this important? Because you just can't do it any way you want to. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us specifically how to recite the Quran, and this has been passed down to us generation after generation. And we're afraid now it might get lost because of the internet and everything. People are just doing what they want to. So we want to clarify these particular ways of doing it. So that's the second way. The third way is to join all of these together. Okay? Now we said we joined these two. Now we're going to join all three. So now I'm going to say Rahimi here. And when I do that, normally I say what? Alhamdulillah. But see, this Hamza is what we call Hamzatul Wasl. Wasl means to join. So when we're combining all three, we join the previous sound. So the previous sound is a mi. So we're going to say Rahimil Hamdulillah when we join them together. Now, what you need to know is that we're not going to pause here. So you need to take a big breath. This is something some people don't know. What's the difference between the hafiz and the person who's studying? The hafiz knows how much air he needs to finish the line. And that's only done through practice. So take a deep breath in through your nose. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. So that is joining all of them together. Okay? Now there is the fourth way. What's the fourth way? The fourth way is when we single out the ta'awudh and we join the Bismillah and the beginning of the surah. Okay? Now this way, a lot of people like that because they get to think. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. You see, we joined these two, the beginning of the Bismillah with the beginning of the surah. And we pause between the ta'awudh and that beginning. Those are the four ways that you can begin to recite the Quran. Learn them, practice them, and utilize them, and don't use any other way. What are some of the ways? People just, I don't know what they want to do, but this is what you have to do. I don't even want to promote the ways that they do it wrong. We only want to promote what's right. This has been a tidbit in the Quran, some little bit of rules that hopefully you benefit from. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر لي ولكم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله.